ministers of the governor took Jesus into the common hall and gathered unto him the whole band of soldiers. And then they stripped him and put on a scarlet robe. And when they had plaited a crown of thorns, they put it upon his head, and a reed in his right hand, and they bowed the knee before him, and mocked him, saying, "Hail, King of the Jews!" And they spit upon him, and took the reed, and smote him on the head. And after that they had mocked him, they took the robe off from him, and put his own raiment on him, and led him away to crucify him. And as they came out, they found a man of Cyrus, Simon by name, and him that compelled to bear his cross. And when they were come unto the place called Golgotha, that is to say, a place of a skull, they gave him vinegar to drink, mingled with gall. And when he had tasted thereof, he would not drink. And they crucified him, and they parted his garments, casting lots, that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by the prophet. They parted my garments among them, and upon my vesture they did cast lots. And sitting down, they watched him, and set up over his head his accusation written, "This is Jesus, the King of the Jews." They were there with two thieves crucified with him, one on the right hand and another on the left. And they passed by, reviled him, wagging their heads, and saying, "Thou that destroyest the temple and buildest in 3 days, save thyself. If thou be the Son of God, come down from the cross." Likewise also the chief priests mocking him with the scribes and the elders said, "He saved others, himself he cannot save. If he be the King of Israel, let him now come down from the cross, and we will believe him. He trusted in God, let him deliver him now. If he will have him, for he said, 'I am the Son of God.'" The thieves also, which were crucified with him, cast the same in his teeth. Now, from the sixth hour there was darkness over all the land unto the ninth hour. And about the ninth hour, Jesus cried out in a loud voice, saying, "Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani?" This is to say, my God, why hast thou forsaken me?" Some of them that stood there, when they heard that, said, This man called Eli." And straightway one of them ran and took a sponge and filled it with vinegar and put it on a reed and gave him to drink. The rest said, "Let us see whether Eli will come to save him." Jesus, when he cried again with a loud voice, yielded up the ghost. And behold, the veil of the temple was rent in twain from the top to the bottom, and the earth did quake, and the rocks rent. And the graves were opened, and many bodies of the saints which slept rose. And they came out of the graves after his resurrection, and went into the holy city, and appeared unto many. Now, the centurion, and that they were with him, watching Jesus, saw the earthquake and those things that were done. They feared greatly, saying, "Truly, this was the Son of God."
you're aware, you realize that I have three cups for our ushers, and that there's still a cup on the table. Because in that very first communion, when Jesus said, with great desire, I have desired to eat this with you, he took the cup first, and he supped it, and he gave it to his disciples and said, drink all of it. He says, because I'm not going to drink it anymore until I drink it anew with you in the kingdom of a mighty God. Every once in a while, somebody will ask me if I'm a person that believes in abstinence, and I smile and I say, yes. And there are a few reasons why, but one of those reasons is my Savior is waiting until we're all there together to celebrate. If he's waiting, I too will wait. Hence we pour the cup for the Savior, because his presence is indeed here today. The Apostle Paul says it this way, for I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread, blessed it, broke it, gave it to his disciples and said, take, eat ye all of it. For this is my body, which is broken for you, because he loved us so. Let us eat together. The same manner also, Jesus took the cup, and when he had supped, he gave it to his disciples and said, take, drink ye all of it. For this is the new covenant of my blood, which is shed for many for the remission of sins. For as often as you drink this cup, eat this bread and drink this cup, you do show forth the Lord's death until he comes. Lord, this year, we're looking for a fresh, new touch from you. We're putting out our hand, Lord, because we know yours is already extended. That we might know your own divine presence. Once again, not just renewing, Lord God, but taking us farther than we have been before. Lord, that it might be apparent that we have been in the presence of a mighty God. God, that your Spirit in us, Lord, will lay convicting power around to those near us, Lord, that they will weep in repentance, not because of us, but because of the God in us, and see his salvation alive and well and moving in us. We ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's drink together. Hallelujah. 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 Joe's going to play a song as he plays it. Worship of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. also his searching penetrate our hearts. And as we go from this place, let us realize we are not going from the presence of God, but only into the mission field where God has placed us to be his lights in the darkness, that the darkness will not be able to overcome it, but that the light will penetrate the darkness, his light, in us. Amen. God bless you. Greet one another.